All right, good afternoon again, everybody. Normally, I would jump right into our first tune before I speak, but I did want to mention that we're so thrilled to be able to play for people live, and I figure I should introduce this first tune entitled Joy Revisited, and I think for a lot of us, it's the joy of being able to play, not just together, but for people again. So here's Joy Revisited.
Thank you.
that's one of my favorite pieces ever written for a wind band, entitled October by Eric Whitaker, who's so famous for his choral music, but obviously the guy knows how to write for a band as well. From that, we're going to move to something a little bit lighter called American Riversongs, and without naming them, see if you can figure out how many different traditional American tunes you can pick out of this medley. American Riversongs. Thank you. I was trying to count the number of American traditional tunes in there, but I actually lost count. So did anyone keep track? No, probably not. All right, so moving on, speaking of American composers, one of the greatest American composers ever, Aaron Copland. This is adapted for wind band. It was originally a piece for choir from an entire musical entitled The Tender Land, and this is The Promise of Liberty.
Thank you.
while I've been here at Cabrillo College the past year and a half, it's been among many pleasures here to get to know somebody who's very heavily involved in music here at Cabrillo, as well as the Santa Cruz County, probably Monterey County as well. But this person not only is an amazing musician on their instrument, but has become quite prolific at composing and arranging pieces for ensembles. And this is an original arrangement of Bruckner's Prelude and Fugue in D minor by Jackie Rosette.
Thank you.
don't know if I should have prepped you before that piece or not. But I kind of, as we were playing it, I kind of liked the idea of blindsiding you with that, as opposed to letting you know what was about to happen, which we didn't know what was about to happen either, to be honest. So, yes, there were a lot of intentional effects and unusual sounds coming from instruments and combinations of instruments, as well as a whole set of kitchen bowls. Yeah. Who would have expected that at this concert? And thanks to Deb for buying those beautiful sounding bowls. Got a couple numbers for you. This next one, well, it's an old classic, but one of our students actually was talking to me privately and described it as clowns at a horse race. So here we go, folk dancing.
Thank you.
thank you so much. So that's folk dances. I don't know if you were really thinking about the fine little horse race when you wrote that, but it kind of did. All right, thank you so much for spending your Sunday afternoon with us. We're so thrilled to be able to play music for live people instead of a YouTube audience, which we're grateful for, but it's definitely not the same thing, right? So thank you so much. I was gonna end with one holiday number, but I got talked into adding a second movement of this. So here are two movements from Medieval Christmas. Thank you.